I am Dee Dee.
I'm Matthew.
Chris.
I'm Anthony.
And I'm Emmy.
We're going to be reading The Gruffalo's Child by Julia Donaldson.
Julia Donaldson.
The Gruffalo said that no Gruffalo should ever set foot in the deep, dark wood. Why not? Why not? Because if you do, the big, bad mouse will be after you. I met him once, said the Gruffalo. I met him a long, long time ago. What does he look like? Tell us, Dad. Is he terribly big and terribly bad? I can't quite remember, the Gruffalo said. Then he thought for a minute and scratched his head.
The big fat mouse is terribly strong and his scaly tail is terribly long. His eyes are like coals of terrible fire and his terrible whiskers are stiffer than wire.
I'm so scared.
One snowy night when Gruffalo snored, the Gruffalo's child was feeling bored. The Gruffalo's child is feeling brave, so she's tiptoed out of the Gruffalo's cave. The snow fell fast and the wind blew wild. Into the woods went the Gruffalo's child. Ah, oh, a trail in the snow. Who is this trail and where does it go? The tail poked out of a long log pile house. Could this be the tail of the big fat mouse?
Okay, so outside the creature, his eyes were small and he didn't have whiskers. No, not at all. You're not the mouse. No, I, said the snake. He's down by the lake, eating Gruffalo's cake. So the snow fell fast and the wind blew wild. I'm not scared, said the Gruffalo's child. Marks in the snow. Well, whose are these claw marks? Where do they go? Two eyes gleamed out the treetop house. Could these be the eyes of the big fat mouse? Nah. Down flew the creature. His tail was short and he didn't have whiskers of any sort. You're not the mouse. To who? Not I. But he's somewhere nearby eating Gruffalo's pie. The snow fell fast and wild blew wild. Man, wind blew wild. I'm not scared, said Gruffalo's child.
Aha, a hole. A track in the snow. Whose is this track and where does it go? Whiskers at last and an underground house. Could this be the home of the big bad mouse? Out slunk the creature, his eyes were in fury, his tail wasn't scaly. His whiskers weren't wiry. You're not the mouse. Oh no, not me. He's under a tree, drinking Gruffalo tea. It's all a trick, said the Gruffalo's child as she sat on the stump where the snow lay piled. I don't believe in the big bad mouse. But here comes a little one out of his house. Not big, not bad, but a mouse at least, you'll taste good as a midnight feast.
Wait, said the mouse, before you eat, there's a friend of mine that you ought to meet. If you let me hop onto a hazy twig, I'll beckon my friend so bad and big. The Gruffalo child unclenched her fist, the big bad mouse, so he does exist. The mouse hopped into the hazel tree. He beckoned then said, just wait and see. Out of the moon, it was bright and round. A terrible shadow fell onto the ground. Who is this creature, so big, bad, and strong? His tail and his whiskers are terribly long. His ears are enormous. And over his shoulders, he carried a nut as big as a boulder. The big bad mouse, yelled the Gruffalo child. The mouse jumped down from the twig and smiled. Aha! Aho! Prince in the snow. Whose are these footprints? Where do they go? The footprints led to the Gruffalo cave, where the Gruffalo child was a bit less brave. The Gruffalo child was a bit less bored. And the Gruffalo sound and snored and snored. The end.
Oh! Merry Christmas!